Hello and welcome to this session. In this session, we are going to discuss how to find the volume of right rectangular prisms and pyramids. First of all, let us discuss how to find the volume of right rectangular prisms. Now, a rectangular prism is a three-dimensional figure whose all faces are rectangles. And a right rectangular prism is a prism in which the base faces are perpendicular to the joining edges. Now this is a right rectangular prism, which is a three-dimensional figure whose all the faces are rectangles and the base faces are perpendicular to the joining edges. And here L, W and H are the length, width and height respectively of this right rectangular prism. Now we know that volume of any solid is the space occupied by that solid or the capacity of that solid. Now let us learn how to find the volume of a right rectangular prism. Now volume of any solid is measured in cubic units . That is, the number of cubes of unit volume required to fill the solid completely, like blocks in a box or bricks in a wall. Volume of any three-dimensional figure is its area of base into height. So for a right rectangular prism, with length L, width W and height H, area of the base, that is the area of this rectangular base with length L and width W, will be equal to L into W. And the height of the prism is H. So the volume of the right rectangular prism is equal to area of its base into height. Now area of the base is L into W and height is H. So this is equal to L into W the whole into H, which is equal to LWH. Now suppose we want to find the volume of a wall with dimensions 10 meters by 5 meters by 8 meters and at the wall is made up of bricks of unit length, width and height. Now we shall find the number of bricks required to make the wall now as the length of the wall is 10 meters, therefore number of bricks of unit length required along the length of the wall will be 10. Similarly, as the width of the wall is 5 meters, so the number of bricks of unit length required along the width of the wall is 5. This means in one row of bricks we will have 5 into 10, that is equal to 50 bricks. Also, height of the wall is 8 meters, therefore number of bricks of unit length required along the height is 8. So there will be 8 rows of bricks with 50 bricks in each row. So the required number of bricks to make the wall is equal to 8 into 50, which is equal to 400 bricks. Now as the bricks are of unit length, width and height, so each brick is a cube of size 1 meter and as the whole wall is made up of 400 bits. So the volume of the wall will be 400 cubic meter. Now by the formula we have volume of a right rectangular prism is equal to LWH . Now applying the formula, we can find the volume of the wall which is a right rectangular prism. So the volume of the wall will be equal to LWH. Now length of the wall is 10 meters, width is 5 meters and height is 8 meters. Putting all these values here, this is equal to 10 into 5 into 8, which is equal to 400 cubic meter. So directly by applying the formula, we can find out the volume of the wall. So we can find the volume of a rectangular prism if the length, width and height of the rectangular prism are given to us. Now let us see one remark. If length, width and height of a rectangular prism are in meters, then the volume is in cubic meter and if length, width and height are in centimeters, then the volume of the prism, that is the volume of the rectangular prism, is in cubic centimeter. Also, the units of all the three dimensions should be same. That is, the units of length, width and height should be same. If not, then we will convert all the three dimensions into same units and then we will apply the formula to find out the volume of the prism. Now a pyramid is a three-dimensional figure. Base is a polygon and the lateral faces are triangles. Joined at a single vertex and the apex. Now this is a pyramid which is a three-dimensional figure whose base is a polygon and the lateral faces are the triangles joined at a single vertex which is called the apex. Now volume of a pyramid is one third the area of the base into the height of the apex. That is 1 by 3 into B, where B is the area of the base, into H, where H is the height of the apex. Or you can say H is the height of the pyramid. Now suppose a tent made of canvas is of the shape of a rectangular pyramid . Now suppose this is a tent made of canvas which is in the shape of rectangular pyramid and the base has length 3 feet, width 5 feet and height of the tent is 6 feet. Now here B, that is the area of the base, is equal to area of the rectangle. As the base is rectangular in shape, so this is equal to L into W, that is the length into width, which is equal to 3 feet into 5 feet, which is equal to 15 square feet. And height H is equal to 6 feet. Therefore, volume is equal to 1 by 3 into area of the base, that is 15 square feet, into height, that is 6 feet. Now 3 into 5 is 15 and 5 into 6 is 30. So this is equal to 30 cubic feet. So the volume of the tent is equal to 30 cubic feet. Now let us see one interesting fact, and that is we can divide a rectangular prism into three pyramids formed by taking the vertex A as apex of each of the pyramid . The basis of pyramids formed are CFGB EFGH and EDCF. So using this fact we can find the volume of the prism by finding the sum of the volumes of the three pyramids. So in this session we have studied the volumes of prisms and pyramids. And this completes our session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.